So what we're going to look at now is we're going to look at some very basic applications of working with vectors in two-dimensional space. So let's look at something like that we have a car that's stuck in the mud. And a tow truck, which is the same height as the car, is pulling the car with a force of 300 pounds. So it's pulling out of the car. So you can imagine you've got your car stuck in the mud. Okay, it doesn't happen a lot here in California, but sometimes it does. So it errs. And then you've got a tow truck. Okay, and the tow truck is pulling, it's completely horizontal. And so this thing here, we're pulling in this direction, okay, in that horizontal direction going, in the case of this, we'll call it east, east. And it's got a force, and that force is gonna be 300 pounds. 300 pounds of force. And so in this case, that magnitude is 300 equals the force, right? And so remember when I talked about magnitude, when we talk about magnitude, it's not always just a length. Sometimes when we're working with different applications, it might have a different representation. It might be speed, it might be speed, or in this case, it's gonna be a force. So it's 300 pounds. Now we got two people, they're at the back, and they're going to actually be pushing, okay? And they're pushing kind of with an upward force, so they're kind of underneath the car, right? Trying to get it up and over, okay? And they're pushing, and they've got, you'll see an upward angle of 30 degrees. So there's your upward angle, their angle theta of 30 degrees. And they've got a force of 200 pounds that they're exerting. Okay, there's two of them. Maybe if we were gonna be really rational, we should really say that, you know, the truck's got like 5,000 pounds of force, or a lot more force than just two people pushing, but whatever, we're gonna go with what we've got, okay? Now, the thing about this is we're just gonna imagine adding these two vectors together, okay? We're gonna add these two vectors together. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to imagine what happens if we do that. So we're gonna take, this is gonna be 300 pounds, okay? So there's our first vector. It's 300 in a completely horizontal, the length is 300 pounds in a horizontal direction. And then we're gonna add to that something that's at a 30 degree angle, okay? So it's got a 30 degree angle, and it's got a magnitude of 200 pounds. Okay, and that's its magnitude. And so the resulting vector, and let me put this down here, 200 pounds, the resulting vector is going to be the addition of those two vectors. That's what we're looking for when we talk about that resultant force, or the resultant vector. Okay, so we've got this vector, and we're gonna use that tip-to-tail method, right? Basically, it's the addition of the two vectors, right? We've got this quadrilateral, and that's essentially what we're going to be doing. So what we need to do is we need to figure out what the two vectors are, add them together, okay, to get that resultant force, and then we need to figure out its magnitude and direction once we've found it. So what we're going to do is we're going to first say, well, what is this, this 300-pound one? All right, it's going straight across. Its length is 300. So the way that we might imagine it is just calling it 300i. So this one here, V equals 300i. Okay, and use our standard unit vectors. Equivalently, that's 300 comma zero. Our W vector, which is the people pushing the vector, W is gonna end up equaling, well, we've got the magnitude and we've got this angle, so W is going to end up equaling 200 times the cosine of 30, I. So this is gonna be, that's gonna be the length of the x direction, right? Is 200 times cosine 30 plus 200 times sine 30, and that's the y direction, and then that'll be times j, okay? And again, these are our standard unit vectors. So if you want, go and take a look at the standard unit vector video, and that should kind of help you with these. Just to give you a sense, when it comes to the vectors, it's gonna be 200 cosine 30 comma 200 sine 30, and there it is. Our resultant force then is just gonna be the addition of those two. So V plus W is gonna equal 300 plus 200 plus 200 cosine 30. So we'll add the X components, I, plus, and then there's no Y component in V, so we're just gonna have 200 sine 30. Okay, J, and that's our resultant vector. So there's the resultant force, resultant vector. Okay, so there's our resultant vector. Let's say, for example, that what we want to know is we want to know what the magnitude is now. Okay, what we'll do, I'm actually just going to go in, I'm going to calculate these things, find them as decimals. You know, that's probably the easiest way. So what I'm going to do, right, is I'm going to take, I've got this portion right here, that's two, that ends up being, .473.205 I plus, and then we'll have 200 sine 30 or sine pi over 6 either, and then that equals, that ends up being 100 J. Okay, and so to find the magnitude in this case of our resulting vector of V plus W, its magnitude, we're going to end up equaling, that's going to be squared plus that'll end up equaling the square root of 233,922.972, which ends up equaling 483.6558 pounds. So put together, that's going to be actually that force, the magnitude of the force. And then what I want to do is I can just go in and I can say, okay, well, now that I know that that's the case, okay, I'm going to take, I've got, here's the x value. So I've got 473.205 is going to equal 483.6558 cosine theta, right? Because this is going to be, we've got x will end up equaling the magnitude of V cosine theta. So we've got 473.205 divided by 483.6558. And then we'll take cosine inverse. And so theta, in terms of radians, will end up being 0.20826. Okay. If we change that into degrees, so we will, we end up getting that theta is approximately 11.93 degrees. So there it is. Essentially, when we're dealing with these like these resultant force problems, what we're going to do is we're going to actually just add vectors. So we're going to need to figure out what each vector is, utilize, you know, either some pictures or some thinking our way through the problem. Once we figure that out, then we're going to basically add the two vectors together, and their magnitudes are just a matter of finding the magnitude of the addition of the two vectors. And to find the angle, you just go in and utilize that fact that our x is going to equal the magnitude times cosine theta, and that y is going to equal the magnitude times sine theta. All right, so let's take a look at another problem. Let's say, for example, I've got an airplane that flies due west at an airspeed of 520 miles per hour, and the wind is blowing from the northeast at 40 miles per hour. What is the ground speed of the airplane, and then what is the bearing of the airplane? All right, so what I want to imagine is I've got my airplane. So here's my airplane, okay? It's kind of a terrible airplane. I've got my airplane. It's flying due west. So exactly due west. And we're going to imagine, we're going to say that our airspeed is going to be the magnitude of that vector here. So this is the vector V. And the magnitude of V is equal to 520 miles per hour. So speed in this case, or airspeed, is going to be end up being our magnitude. Okay, so we're going directly west. And V is going to equal 520 miles per hour. Now, the air we're having is going northeast. So you're imagining it's going directly northeast. And that's going to end up being a 45 degree angle, if you kind of think about it. Okay, because we're not told anything else other than it's going northeast. So there's that 45 degree angle. So that equals 45 degrees. And its airspeed is 40 miles per hour. Okay, so essentially, if you want to kind of imagine what's happening here, what's happening is that the air, we've got a headwind. So it's probably we should expect that our plane's going slower, actually. The real ground speed is slower than 520 miles per hour, okay? Because it's being, you know, kind of bombarded by air, and its heading is going to come off a little bit because that air is being pushed to the 45-degree angle, okay? From a math perspective, all we've got to do is just add vectors, okay? So my first vector, right, it's got a, by the way, this is W, and that's the magnitude of W. My first vector is just simply going to be V equals, and it'll be negative 520i. Okay, so negative 520i, and that's because if you imagine, if I'm going west, we're just going to imagine that west is in a negative direction. East will be our positive direction, west is our negative. Doesn't really matter, it just matters that from the standpoint of the Cartesian plane, that's what's happening. Okay, now, when it comes to when it comes to W is going to end up equaling our magnitude of 40, and it'll be 40 cosine 45 I plus 40 sine 45 J. Okay, so 40 cosine 45 I plus 40 sine 45 J. So let's figure out what those are. So what we get here is that we get that then W equals 28.284i plus 28.284j. Makes sense, because it's at a 45-degree angle. So what we're going to do now is we're actually just going to go through and add them together. So V plus W is then going to equal negative 520 plus 28.284 I plus 28.284 J, okay? And so that ends up equaling negative 491.715 I plus 28.284 J. And that's our resultant vector. You can also write it in component form as negative 491.715 comma 28.284. Okay? When you think about this means actually that it's going to be moving in the northwest direction just slightly. It'll be running just slightly into the northwest direction because you've got a positive y, okay, and a negative x, all right? So what we want to do now is we want to find its magnitude. So all we've got to do here is we've just got to use our Pythagorean distance. So we'll call this new resulting vector, we'll call it y. So that our magnitude of y is going to end up equaling negative 491.715 squared plus 28.284 squared, and then we'll take the square root of that. And that equals 492.5285, and that would be miles per hour. Okay, so it slowed down a little bit, and that makes sense because it's getting hit directly with a headwind, or maybe not directly, but pretty directly with a headwind. So there's our magnitude, and now in order to figure out what theta is our bearing, okay, let's take our x value in this case. So negative 491.715 is going to equal, and it'll be our magnitude, 492.5285. And then cosine theta, okay? And now all we've got to do is we've just got to go figure out what theta is. So if I go in here and I do that, I end up getting that theta equals 176.706 degrees. But like, if you're thinking about that, here's the deal with that though, okay? That's actually with regard to the positive x-axis. So there's that theta there, okay? And so it's really all the way out here. There's your theta, okay? And what we really want to do is we want to kind of characterize it in terms of the direction in which we're moving. So I'm going to then have my theta 2 is going to be 180 minus 176.706. That way, that's going to help me to figure out what this angle is right here. There's my theta, okay, which equals 3.2935. So the bearing would be 3.2935 degrees north, and there we are. So what we've done there, we've done basically the same process as we did before. We just said, okay, well, I've got two vectors. One is going to be the vector in which the airplane is moving. The other one is the wind speed. I'm just going to add those two vectors together. Then I'll go find its direction and its magnitude, or the degrees and the magnitude. Okay. Just remember, when you're writing something as a bearing, you're always going to be writing in terms of the direction. So you want to like kind of adjust your angles appropriately. Okay. All right. So that's actually how the applications work. Basically, go find the vectors and add them together.